In this video, I will show how to take into account prior information for Bayesian estimation of population parameters in monoliths. Let's begin with an example. In this project, we estimate a simple one-compartment model with an oral administration and a PK of warfarin. The parameters are estimated with a good confidence, but we notice that Ka-pop and omega-Ka are the hardest parameters to estimate. This uncertainty is explained by the lack of information in the data. Indeed, as we can see on the plot of the observed data, 19 of the 32 patients have no measured data in the first 24 hours after taking the drug. Therefore, these subjects give little information on the absorption process for the drug. But what if I have prior information on the value of Ka-pop? For example, let's assume that I know from a previous study that the absorption rate is close to 1. I can take into account this prior information by changing the estimation method in the tab Initial Estimates. If I click here, I see that the default estimation method is maximum likelihood estimation. In that case, Ka-pop is estimated based on the data only. If I am very certain of the prior information and have no confidence in the data to estimate Ka-pop, I can just fix Ka-pop to 1 with this option. In that case, it will not be estimated. Fixed parameters appear in orange in the tab Initial Estimate. If I still want to estimate Ka-pop based on the data but taking also into account the prior value, I can choose a Bayesian estimation method called maximum a posteriori estimation. This allows me to define a prior distribution for Ka-pop, which is the same type of distribution as the one used for the parameter, so log normal here, with the prior value as the typical value, and the standard deviation of the transformed parameter that represents the certainty of this prior information and directly impacts the weight that it will have in the estimation. For example, I would choose a standard deviation of 0.1. Parameters to be estimated with the Bayesian approach are colored in purple. After running the population parameter estimation with SAEM, I can see that the estimated value for Ka-pop is now closer to 1. Let's now detail what the Bayesian estimation approach means. The default estimation method in monoliths maximizes the likelihood, which is the joint distribution of the observed data and the population parameters. The Bayesian approach considers the vector of population parameters theta as a random vector with a prior distribution pi. It is then possible to define the posterior distribution of theta like here. We can estimate this conditional distribution and the value of theta that maximizes it. It is called the maximum a posteriori estimate of theta. The conditional distribution can be decomposed as here with the log likelihood that appears for the maximization. So the maximum a posteriori estimate maximizes a penalized version of the observed likelihood. In other words, maximum a posteriori estimation is the same as penalized maximum likelihood estimation. Of course, it is possible to combine maximum a posteriori estimation for some population parameters and maximum likelihood estimation for the rest. As I have mentioned before, the weight given to the prior directly depends on the variance of the prior distribution. For instance, let's look at an example where theta is a scalar parameter and the prior is a normal distribution with mean theta 0 and standard deviation gamma. Then the maximum a posteriori estimate is the solution of this minimization problem. The solution will be a trade-off between the maximum likelihood estimation, which minimizes the difference to the data, and theta 0, which minimizes this difference, and the smaller gamma is, the closer the solution will be to the prior value theta 0. This slide shows the maximum a posteriori estimates for Ka-pop in the warfarin example that I have shown in monoliths with different values of gamma. The prior value of 1 is displayed on the plot as a blue vertical line, and the estimate of Ka-pop without prior, so given by maximum likelihood estimation and based only on the data, is displayed as a black line. We can compare how the standard deviation of the prior distribution will impact the maximum a posteriori estimate for Ka-pop. With a small value, like 0.02, the prior distribution is very narrow and the maximum a posteriori estimate, visible with the purple vertical line, will be very close to 1. increasing the standard deviation defines a wider prior distribution, so the maximum a posteriori estimate will be closer to the maximum likelihood estimate. The true maximum likelihood estimate is equivalent to the maximum a posteriori estimate with an infinite standard deviation for the prior distribution. So the standard deviation gamma is really the trigger that either keeps the estimate close to the prior or allows it to be very different. A value too small for gamma will constrain strongly the estimate, but a value too high will be meaningless because the weight of the prior in the estimation will be negligible. So the standard deviation of the prior distribution should be chosen based on the confidence that you have on the data or the confidence that you have on the prior. If the prior comes from a previous study, the standard deviation could come from the standard error estimated for this parameter in the study because it represents the uncertainty of the estimate. So if the parameter has a normal distribution in the previous study and the current model, like a baseline response is zero, for example, then the prior distribution is a normal distribution as well, with a standard deviation equals to the estimated standard error. But if the parameter has a log normal distribution in the previous study and the current model, like Ka, for instance, then the prior distribution is a log normal distribution as well, and it is defined by giving the typical value as a prior, so the estimate for Ka pop, and the standard deviation of the corresponding normal distribution. So in that case, the standard error Seka needs to be transformed like this to give the standard deviation gamma. Finally, remember that the choice to use a prior distribution for the estimation of a parameter really depends on each problem. In general, prior information should be used if it is available and if it is relevant, that is, if it can help answer a given question that the data cannot answer because it does not contain sufficient information. You will find all the details on Bayesian estimation on this page on our online documentation. See you next week!